Welcome back to Mr. Spellos Map Tutorials. Today we're going to find the GCF, or also called GCD, and the LCM, so please stay tuned. Alright, let's get started. The GCF stands for Greatest Common Factor, and GCD stands for Greatest Common Divisor. So here we see that factors and divisors are the same thing. And then we're also going to find the LCM. The two numbers we're starting with are 12 and 20. Let's go ahead and do that using the TI Inspire. So here, let's click on the menu button. Let's go down or to number. We could have pressed the number 2. And then let's go down to greatest common divisor, which is number 5. And we said our two numbers are 12 and 20. Click, type those in and press enter. And we see the GCD is 4. Next, we want to find the LCM. So again, we press menu. We go over to number. And then we can go down and press number 4 for least common multiple. Again, place in 12 and 20. And we see that the LCM is 60. Let's also go ahead and use Desmos to verify these answers as well. So GCD of 12 and 20. And we see that that comes out to be 4. And then the LCM of 12 and 20. And we see that also comes out to be 60. So let's go ahead and place that. So the GCF was 4 and the LCM was 60. Let's do the same thing with the two numbers, 108 and 64. So here I can actually type in GCD of 108 and 64. And then I can click the enter button and we see that there comes out to be 4. And let's do the LCM of 108 and 64. And we see that comes out to 1,728. Let's test that also or verify that as well with Desmos. So GCD of 108 and 64, we see that's also 4, and the LCM of 108 and 64, and again we see that's 1,728. Now let's do the next set of numbers here. We have three numbers. Actually, let's go ahead and put these two answers in. The GCF for these two was 4, and the LCM was 1,728. Now notice we have three numbers, 18, 36, and 90. Let's go ahead and go to the TI Inspire. So if I put in GCD and I try to put in all three of those numbers, which were, let's see, 18, 36, and 90, I'm going to get an error, too many arguments. So what I'm going to have to do is, this function only takes two arguments at a time. So what I can do is I can come back and make the second argument here, GCD, function again, and I want to place in the other two numbers, this time 36 and 90. So what you do is basically you place the function inside of itself as many times as necessary if you had more numbers. So here to find the GCD of those three numbers, we see the GCD is 18, and if I do LCM, again, if I try to put in all three, 18, 36, and 90, you see I come up with an error. All I have to do is make LCM an argument inside the function where the other two numbers will be 36 and 90, and see that we do come up with the answer here, which is 180. And let's go ahead and do the same thing with Desmos. Here in Desmos, what you'll notice is when I put in all three numbers, 18, 36, and 90, you see that I do not get an error. Desmos allows me to put in more than just two arguments, and if I put in LCM of those three, 18, 36 and 90, again you see I come up with 180. So here we've verified our results, and again, what was the 18 and 180? So let's go ahead and place that here. All right, well, that sums up this tutorial. If you like it, please like it, and as always, thank you for watching.